Hello everyone. So in this video we will analyze this continuous beam by using force method. It is also called as compatibility method. It is also known as flexibility method. And in some book it is named as method of consistent deformations. So the question will be like this: analyze the continuous beam by force method or by compatibility method, flexibility method, or the method of consistent deformation. So when we are analyzing any structure, any indeterminate structure by force method, the very first step is to find the DS, degree of statical indeterminacy. Degree of statical indeterminacy. Okay, degree of statical indeterminacy we need to determine. And you see in this problem, so directly we can determine ds r minus 3. R is number of reactions, minus 3. Directly in the simple structure, directly we can determine. So you see, what is the number of reactions? You take all the reactions into consideration. Here we have 3 reactions plus 1 plus 1. Okay, so the number of reactions are 5 minus 3. So ds is equal to 2. So ds equal to 2. So this is the very first step in force method. So after determining ds, we need to identify the redundant. So once you identify the redundant, you need to remove the redundant. Okay, so you have your choice of identifying the redundant and removing it. Okay, so number of redundant is equal to ds. So how many number of redundant we have here? We have 2 number of redundant. Okay, so you can remove RB and RC. Okay, you are removing RB and RC means you are removing 2 forces, 2 reactions. Or either you can remove moment at A and RB. Okay, so you have your choice. So when you are removing RB and RC, your structure will become a cantilever structure. Okay, you are removing RB and RC, so your structure will become a cantilever structure. So we are calling this as basic structure. Okay, and one more structure we need to draw, and we don't have to show any given load on it. We only have to show the redundant RB and RC. Okay, so the indeterminate structure is divided into basic structure plus structure with redundant. The name is only given for understanding purpose, structure with redundant. Okay, so in this particular case I have removed RB and RC, but you can also remove moment at A and RB. So if you are removing that, your basic structure will be a simply supported structure. You see, it will be a simply supported structure. What you are removing? You are removing moment at A, MA, and you are removing RB. Okay, so show the given load in the basic structure. So this is your ABC. So I told you, you have your choice of identifying the redundant and removing the redundant. Here we have identified the redundant RB and RC, and we have removed it. So your basic structure is cantilever, and in this case we have removed MA, moment at A, and RB. So hence the basic structure will be a simply supported structure, and this is the structure with redundant. So always it is better to make the basic structure a cantilever structure for easy analysis. Okay, you can also do this, but the analysis will be difficult. If you make the basic structure just as a cantilever beam, your analysis will be very easy. We are having these two structure, basic structure and structure with redundant, and we need to format this table. This table is very important as far as concept is concerned. So we have to define the member. Always you see, whenever you are having a cantilever beam, a basic structure is cantilever, always try to go from free end. Okay, so the first member will be CB, and you see whenever you have a point, you need to take it as a member, point load. Okay, so next member is BD, and after that you have DA. Okay, and you see in the table we have origin, limit, EI, M0. M0 is the moment in the basic structure, the moment developed due to external loading in the basic structure. M1 is, we have two coordinates, coordinate 1 and coordinate 2. Okay, so RB is replaced by unit load and RC is also replaced by unit load. So M1 is developed, M1 is moment developed in the structure due to unit load at coordinate 1 with no other load on the structure, and M2 is developed unit load at coordinate 2, okay, with no other load on the structure. We will see how we can find that. For CB, I will take C as origin. C as origin, this is 6 meter. This is 6 meter. C as origin. So if the C is the origin for CB, you see what will be the limit? What will be the limit? C is at 0 and B is at 6. So the limit will be 0 to 6. Okay. So after that we have BD. I will take B as origin. Okay, if the B is origin, so X distance at B will be 0 and at D it is 2. For BD, you can also take origin C. Okay, if you are taking C as origin, if you are taking C as origin for BD, B will be at 6 and D will be at 8. So if C is origin, the limit is 6 to 8. Okay, but we have taken B as origin, so limit will be 0 to 2. For DA, I will take D as origin, so the limit will be 0 to 3. So EI, they have not given anything, so we will assume that it is constant, it is 1. M0, I told you, moment in the basic structure. Moment in the basic structure, you see, first member is CB. So I will take a section in member CB, and you see already we have defined the origin, so X distance will be from this intensity of UDL is 10 kN per meter. So you travel from C to the section. We have to find what is the moment developed at this particular section in this member. Okay, so from C to the section, you see what is the moment developed, 10 into X into X by 2, and the moment is clockwise, it's a hogging moment. So when we are traveling from right to left, clockwise moment will be taken as negative and the anti-clockwise moment will be taken as positive. So what we are getting here, minus 10 x square by 2, which is equal to minus 5 x square, minus 5 x square, you see. Okay, so next we have BD. For BD, take section in member BD, and already we have defined the origin. Origin is B, and X distance will be from B. But you have to travel, in order to find moment at this particular section, you need to travel from C to the section, but X distance will be from B. Okay, so all the loads from C to the section will be taken in order to find bending moment at this particular section. So you see what is the load? You define the total load for this. Total load for this is 10 into 6. Okay, and the perpendicular distance from this section is this is 3 meter and this is x. Okay, this is 3 meter because it is acting at the center and this is x. So the moment developed at this particular section is minus, because it will create clockwise moment, minus 10 into 6 into the perpendicular distance is 3 plus x. Okay, and the last member we have DA, we have taken origin as D. Okay, so again, in order to find bending moment at this particular section, travel from C to the section, but origin is D, x distance will be from D. Okay, so you have two load, one is UDL and one is this point load. Okay, so first we will take the UDL, minus total load of UDL is minus 10 into 6, and the perpendicular distance with respect to this section. Okay, so this is 3 meter plus 2 meter plus x. Okay, so the total distance is 5 plus x. This is 5 plus x. Okay, minus, we also have one more load is there, minus 16 into x, minus 16 into x. So this is all the members we have taken into consideration. We have calculated m naught for all the members. Okay, now we have to find m1. Okay, so m1 is moment in the structure due to unit load at coordinate 1 with no other load on the structure. So we have to apply unit load at coordinate 1. To find m1, we don't have to change the origin, the limit, whatever the origin and the limit we have taken for m0, it will also be true for m1 and m2. We don't have to change it. Okay, so you see we are applying unit load at coordinate 1. Coordinate 1 is this point and coordinate 2 is this point. So we are applying unit load at coordinate 1, and for CB you see already we have defined the origin. There's no load from C to the section, so m0 for CB, m1 for CB will be 0. For BD, origin is B, so the moment developed at this point is 1 into x. It's an anticlockwise moment, we will take it as positive, 1 into x. Okay, and for DA, you see, for DA, D is the origin, and the perpendicular distance, you see, this is 2 meter. And this is x. So total perpendicular distance with respect to section for this load is 2 plus x. Okay, so 1 into 2 plus x. For m2, what we have to do? For m2, apply unit load at coordinate 2, b, c, d, a. For m2, so the moment at this point is 1 into x. Yes, here it is 1 into x. At this point it will be at this member it will be 1 into 6 plus x, 1 into 6 plus x, and at this section it is 1 into 8 plus x, 1 into 8 plus x. So we have completed the formatting the table. All the contents in the tables are calculated. So now we have to determine this RB and RC. This redundant we have to determine. For that we are making use of compatibility equation. So we have two coordinates, means two compatibility equation will be there. Delta 10 plus F11 RB plus F12 RC equal to 0. Next compatibility equation, delta 20 plus F21 RB plus F22 RC is equal to 0. So this equal to 0 means in the original structure, this is coordinate 1. in the original structure, at this point the deflection is 0. At coordinate 2, in the original structure, at this point the deflection is 0. So that is why this is the compatibility equation for coordinate 1, and this is the compatibility equation for the coordinate 2. By using this equation, we can determine RB and RC. So first we have to determine this all thing, delta 1 0, f 1 1, f 1 2. Okay, so we will determine that first. So delta 1 0, the formula of delta 1 0 is integration of m naught into m 1 divided by er 0 to l. So the first member is CB. CB is the first member, the limit is 0 to 6. Okay. M naught is minus 5x square, and m1 is 0 divided by ei. Ei is constant, okay, into dx. Next we have which member is, next member is BD. BD, the limit of BD is 0 to 2, okay. M0 for BD is minus 60, directly I will write minus 60 into x plus 3 into m1 is x dx divided by er. Okay, so one more member we have, plus integration da member. For da member, the limit is 0 to 3, okay, and this is the m0, minus 65 plus x minus 60x, this is m0 into m1 is 2 plus x dx divided by er. Okay, so directly you can use your calculator and find this delta 1. You can do limit integration very easily from the calculator. So delta 1 0 you'll be getting minus 5830 divided by er. Okay, so this is delta 1 0. Delta 20, the formula of delta 20 is this, m0 into m2 divided by er. So by using the same formula, how we have calculated delta 10, in the same way you can find delta 20. The value is minus 1620 divided by er. F11 is calculated by this formula, m square by ei. Okay, so all the member you take, so this is the value you are getting. F12 is equal to F21, this is the formula, this is the value. F22 equal to this. So you can use your calculator and you can find, these are called flexibility coefficient, delta 1 0 or delta 2 0 are the deflection in the basic structure. Okay, so we can find now RB and RC. By using this compatibility equation, you can find RB and RC. The only unknown components here is RB and RC, rest of the things are known. So we can solve simultaneous equation. So RB will be equal to 76.64 kilonewton, and RC will be equal to 22.60 kilonewton. So we got the value of RB and RC. Now we will see how to draw bending moment diagram for this continuous beam. So we will draw bending moment diagram. You have two span, okay, AB and BC. So first you draw free bending moment diagram. Free bending moment diagram is drawn by assuming the continuous beam as a series of simply supported beam. So AB is simply supported and BC is simply supported. AB is subjected to eccentric load and BC is subjected to UDL. Okay, so for UDL, you know, for simply supported beam, if the simply supported beam is subjected to UDL, then the maximum bending moment will be WL square by 8. So if you solve, you are getting 45. So we are drawing free bending moment diagram. For eccentric load means not at the center. The free bending moment diagram is WAB by L. Okay, so this will be 72 kilonewton meter. Okay, now what you do, you find the end moments. End moments means moment at C, moment at B and moment at A, and incorporate in this bending moment diagram, in this free bending moment diagram. Okay, so I will calculate the end moments. Bending moment at C is equal to 0 because it is the end support and it is a roller support. So bending moment at B, we need to find it's an intermediate support. Okay, so I will travel from C to the B, C to B. So you see 22.60 into 6 meter, it's a anti-clockwise positive. Okay, then you have the UDL minus 10 into 6 into 3. So it will produce the clockwise moment. Total load is acting here and the perpendicular distance with respect to B is 3 meter. Okay, now find bending moment at A. So we are only finding the end moments C, B, A. Find the bending moment at A. You have to travel from C to the A to find bending moment at A. So first force is 22.60 into the perpendicular distance, this is 6 meter, 5 meter, it is 11, minus UDL, you have the UDL 10 into, total load of UDL is 10 into 6, and the perpendicular distance with respect to A is, this is 3 meter, 5 meter, perpendicular distance is 8 meter. Okay, you also have this reaction RB. RB will also come here. RB is 76.64 into 5, and after that you have this load, okay, 60 into 3 minus 60 into 3. So the bending moment at A is minus 28.2 and bending moment at B is minus 44.4 kilonewton meter. Okay, so what we have drawn, the free bending moment diagram. Okay, we have drawn the free bending moment diagram and this is the datum. So free bending moment diagram, you see the sign convention for the free bending moment diagram is if the free bending moment diagram is positive, it will be drawn above the datum. If it is negative, it will be drawn below the datum. Okay, so the free bending moment diagram we are getting positive, but with respect to end moments, you see if the end moments are negative, so I am telling you the sign convention of the end moments. If the end moments are negative, then it will be drawn above the datum. Okay, if the end moments are positive, it will be drawn below the datum. So at C the moment is zero, at B it is minus. Minus means it will be above datum, minus 44.4, minus 44.4. Okay, at A also it is negative, it is 28.2, so it will be drawn like this, 28.2 minus minus. Okay, so this part will be nullified, this part will be nullified. Why? Because this portion we are getting positive and the same portion we are getting negative, so this portion will be nullified. So what is remaining of negative moment? This portion is remaining and this portion positive moment is remaining. So we are getting the net bending moment diagram by superimposing negative moment in the negative moment or hogging moment in the free bending moment diagram. So this is the bending moment diagram. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you very much.